بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، we have been in the bab from the book الذكر والدعاء، فضل التحميد والتكبير والتهليل والتسبيح، the excellence and the virtues of saying Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, and Subhanallah. And these words here, أحب الكلام إلى الله تبارك وتعالى أربع، سبحان الله، الحمد لله، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، ولا يضرك بأيهن بدأت. And these words to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the most beloved of the kalam to Allah, and it doesn't matter in which one of them you begin with. We mentioned some ahadith in this bab concerning the excellence and the virtues of mentioning these words here of the remembrance of Allah. We want to complete this bab with some of the rest of the ahadith that the Shaykh he mentions, and that is an Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إنه خلق كل إنسان من بني آدم على 60 و300 مفصل فمن كبر الله وحمد الله وهلل الله وسبح الله واستغفر الله وعزل حجرا عن طريق الناس أو شوقة أو عظما عن طريق الناس وأمر بمعروف أو نهى عن منكر عدد تلك 60 و300 سلامة فإنه يمشي يومئذ وقد زحزح نفسه عن النار. سبحان الله. رواه مسلم. حديث عظيم. This hadith on the authority of Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها أم المؤمنين that the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم he said that indeed every human being from amongst the progeny of Adam was created upon 60 و300 mafsilin, that they were created and they have 360 mafsilin or sulama or joints that are in between the bones. Whoever makes takbir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says Allahu Akbar wa hamidallah, and he says Alhamdulillah وَهَلَّلُ اللَّهِ, and he says لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَسَبَّحَ اللَّهِ, and he says سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ, and he says أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَعَزَلَ حَجْرًا عَنْ طَرِيقِ النَّاسِ, and he moves a rock or a boulder from the path of the people, or something like a shawka or a bush that is a thorn bush or something that can harm the people, or عَظَمًا عَنْ طَرِيقِ النَّاسِ, or something like a bone or something that is from the things that are in the pathway of the people. And he commands and enjoins that which is ma'roof. And he prohibits and he forbids from that which is munkar. عَدَدَ تِلْكَ 60 و300 سُلَامَ, according to the number or the number of these 360 joints, فَإِنَّهُ يَمْشِي يَوْمَئِذٍ, then indeed, when he's doing that, then he is an individual that is walking, he is an individual that is conducting himself, he is an individual that is proceeding and has saved himself from the fire. وَقَالَ أَبُو تَوْبَةَ رَبَّمَا قَالَ يُمْسِي, or one of the narrators of the hadith said, is it possible that the wording instead of يَمْشِي is يُمْسِي, meaning he arrives at the evening as one who has distance himself or saved himself from the fire. And it's a tremendous hadith. That hadith is connected to the hadith that we mentioned of Abi Dharr, in which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned that for every sulama there is a, or the person wakes up in the morning and he has upon his sulama min ahadikum sadaqah, that there is a charity for him to give for all of those joints upon the body. And then he mentioned those particular actions. The next hadith is the hadith of Abi Malik al-Ash'ari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, At-tuhuru shatru al-iman, walhamdulillahi tamla'u al-mizan, wa subhanallahi walhamdulillahi tamla'ani aw tamla'u ma bayna as-samawati wal-ard, was-salatu nurun, was-sadaqatu burhanun, was-sabru diya'un, والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك. كل الناس يغدو فبائع نفسه فمؤتقها أو موبقها. This hadith also a tremendous hadith. This hadith was collected by Imam Muslim as well in his Sahih on the authority of Abi Malik al-Ash'ari, in which he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, At-tuhur shatru al-iman, that cleansing oneself and purifying oneself according to the legislative purification, inwardly and outwardly, is half of iman. And alhamdulillah is that which fills the scales. And subhanallah walhamdulillah are two things that will fill what is in between the heavens and the earth. Subhanallah. Wassalatu nurun, and the salat is a light. وَالصَّدَقَةُ بُرْهَانٌ, and صَدَقَة is a burhan. صَدَقَة is a clear evidence of the iman of the individual. وَالصَّبْرُ ضِيَاءٌ, and patience is an illumination. وَالْقُرْآنُ حُجَّةٌ لَكْ أَوْ عَلَيْكَ, and the Qur'an is either going to be a proof for a person or against a person. كُلُّ النَّاسِ يَغْدُو فَبَاعِيُ نَفْسَهُ فَمُؤْتِقُهَا أَوْ مُوبِقُهَا. And every person, every soul is a soul and a person that is going about during the day about their business. Either they are a person that is saving themselves, freeing themselves, and liberating themselves from the punishment of Allah, or they are those who are destroying themselves and laying themselves subject to the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala anhu qal, جاء عربي إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال علمني كلاما أقوله. قال قل لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, الله أكبر كبيرا, والحمد لله كثيرا, سبحان الله رب العالمين, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العزيز الحكيم. فقال فهؤلاء لربي فما لي؟ قال قل اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني واهدني وارزقني, رواه مسلم. Another hadith that is tremendous. This hadith on the authority of Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that a Bedouin Arab came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, teach me some statements, or teach me a statement that I can say it, meaning statement of remembrance of Allah. He told him, say لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, and nothing deserves the right to be worshipped besides Allah Ta'ala, and nothing has the haq to be worshipped besides Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, and He is alone, and there are no partners for Him in His rububiyya, uluhiyya, wasma wa sifat. And to say Allahu Akbar kabiran, and to say Alhamdulillahi kathiran, and say Subhanallahi Rabbil Alameen, and to say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العزيز الحكيم, which also these kalimat here are from al-baqiyat as-salihat. They're from those in which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said al-baqiyat as-salihat, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu akbar, la hawla wala quwwata illa billah. These are those things that if we say them sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with ikhlas, with hoping for the reward of Allah, fearing the punishment of Allah, hoping for the Jannah of Allah, hoping for the blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these are those things that you will see and will remain, and they will be there on your scales, they will be there in your record, Yawm al-Qiyam. He goes on and he says, the Bedouin Arab, he said to him, فَهَاوْلَاي لِرَبِّي فَمَالِي, these words here are for my Lord, what is there for me? And this is always the Bedouin Arabs in the hadith, when we find how frank they were in their speech and what they would say to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, قُلْ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي, for you say, O Allah, forgive me. وَارْحَمْنِي, have mercy upon me. وَارْزُقْنِي, وَهْدِينِي, and guide me, give me hidayah. وَارْزُقْنِي, and give me provisions. Collected by Imam Muslim. The last hadith in this bab, we will mention inshaAllah ta'ala, this is a pretty long bab, is the famous hadith that we mentioned more than one time in these sittings, and that is the hadith on the authority of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn Al-As, Abi Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, collected by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, in which he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are two kalima, there are two statements that are very light upon the tongue and are very heavy upon the scale and are very beloved to Ar-Rahman. What are they? Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. And if we look at the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, one of the intricate things about the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah ta'ala, is you look at the first hadith and you look at the last hadith, subhanAllah, put them together, this is a tremendous thing. Sahih Shaykh, what is the first hadith? إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. The first hadith Imam Bukhari puts in his book is إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. That indeed all actions are only based upon and judged based upon the intention. Encouraging ikhlas in the niyyah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, showing that the most smallest thing done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be rewarded, and the greatest thing not done for the sake of Allah ta'ala will not be rewarded. The smallest amount of money given sadaqah with ikhlas will weigh tremendously more than the $1 million that a person gave with no ikhlas. $1 with ikhlas is worth way more than $1 million without ikhlas. Very simple, very easy. Right? And what is the last hadith? كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان. Two words, very easy. Beginning with Tawheed and ending with Tawheed, his Sahih, but also showing the tremendous benefit of Al-Islam. The tremendous benefit of Al-Islam, like the hadith the Prophet ﷺ talked about, that we are the people, that we will be the last to come but the foremost of Yawmul Qiyamah. We'll be the last to come but the foremost of Yawmul Qiyamah. In the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, he made the distinction between us and the Yahud and the Nasara. Of what? The people who worked for someone. Some worked how many? How long? A whole day. Some worked a part of the half a day. Some worked a little less than that. Right? Showing the tremendous nature of the people of Islam and the benefit of the people of Islam. We are the last to come and be the foremost Yawmul Qiyamah. Allahu Tabarak wa Ta'ala, with regards to our legislation and what He mandated upon us in our Sharia, is more easier than the Sharia of the Yahud, of the people that came before us. Their Sharia was difficult upon them in many different ways, right? They can only pray where? Inside of a place of prayer, or synagogue, whatever they call it, right? The whole earth was not a masjid for them. It wasn't, the whole earth was not tahur for them, right? If their women were on menstrual cycle, what was the situation? What was the situation? They had to stay totally far away from them. Nowhere near them. They made their religion difficult upon them. Allah Ta'ala has made the religion of Islam easy upon us. Very easy upon us. And these words of remembrance and the rewards that come with them are an indication of how easy Allah Ta'ala has made the means and the ways for the people of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to draw near to him and to reach his Jannah. هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.